We're going to be reading Luke chapter 7, I'm inviting you to open the book of Luke, chapter 7. We're going to be reading from 1 to 5. Luke chapter 7, 1 to 5. If you got it, you can please stand up. We honor the word of God. Luke chapter 7. We are reading from 1 to 5. If you got it, please, can you stand up? Can you read in English, David, please?
When Jesus had finished saying all these things to the people, he went to Capernaum. A Roman officer there had a servant who was very dear to him. The man was sick and about to die. When the officer heard about Jesus, he sent some Jewish elders to ask him to come and heal his servant. They came to Jesus and begged him earnestly. This man really deserves your help. He loves our people, and he himself built a synagogue for us. Amen. Amen.
I'm reading in Jesus' name. Quand Jésus eut fini d'adresser toutes ses paroles à la foule qui l'entourait, il se rendit à Capernaum. Là, un capitaine romain avait un serviteur qui lui était très cher. Ce serviteur était malade et près de mourir. Quand le capitaine entendit parler de Jésus, il lui envoya quelques anciens de Juifs pour lui demander de venir guérir son serviteur. Ils arrivèrent auprès de Jésus et se mirent à le prier avec insistance en disant, « Cet homme mérite que tu lui accordes ton aide. Il aime notre peuple et celui qui a bâti notre synagogue. » Amen.
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 You may sit down, please. Sharing our message, we will share about the bad choices. Bad choices. Bad choices. We read portion of the Bible that is telling us what happened.
Bishop, give me one of those Bibles, please. I want to use that. We just read Luke 7 from 1 to 5. And our message is about the bad choices. Amen.
Amen.
We want to talk about choices that we do in our life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All of us, we are called to make a decision. We are called to choose. Somehow, in some situation, hallelujah.
Amen.
And your way of choosing, your choice, may lead you to something good, to something greater, or to something bad. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why when you are choosing something, you need to be careful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't just choose by emotion. You don't just copy because somebody is doing that. Somebody has collected that or selected that. I have to copy them. No. You need to think. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to see the thing. You need to observe properly. And you need to decide what to choose. Amen.
Amen.
But here the Bible is telling us about a boss. This boss the Bible call him a centurion. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And this guy was a captain of army. And as a captain of army, he's an officer of a military officer, whatever you call it. He have people under him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He lead people in the army. Group of soldiers. But his situation was a little bit different because he also have workers at home. People who work from him. For him, sorry. At home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But one of the servants becomes sick. And the sickness was serious, and they start losing hope, and they were thinking, no, this guy may just die. Amen.
Amen.
Because there was no improvement for the situation. But it happened that Jesus was passing by. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus was passing by, and they heard that Jesus is in the town. Amen.
Amen.
Then the captain called some servants and sent them to go and meet Jesus, to beg him to come to help the servant that was sick. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Glory be to my God. He send people to go and beg Jesus to come. Look, this guy was rich. And he has so many servants. And one was sick. But now, is because he's a caring man. And he was desperate. He wanted the situation to be resolved. I believe they tried so many ways. I believe they tried other ways in order to find the answer, but nothing was improving. But finally they heard that Jesus is in a town. That's why he sent people to go and meet Jesus and to beg him to come in his home in order to pray for this servant that was sick, that was dying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I remember, if I have to put myself, or we have to put ourselves in that time, a servant was not somebody that we value too much. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 We don't value them. Especially when you, in that time, you still can buy slaves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when you have many servants also, why just stick to one? Why just him? Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if you read the Bible, they will say, when they went there, they was begging Jesus, they said, no, this man is a good servant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is a really a good servant. The Bible says, when they came to Jesus, they pleaded earnestly with him. This man deserved to have you do this, because he loved our nation and has built our synagogue. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's a servant. But because of what he has done, because of the things that he did previously, he loved the nation where he was working, the nation of his boss. He loved the people of the country where he's working. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they say, not just he loved our nation, but also he built our church. Amen.
Amen.
You see, the quality that the servant had, that was the thing that touched the heart of the people and the heart of his boss. Amen.
Amen.
Because if you are a lazy servant, the boss will not, it will not be bothering because of you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But he know that this man is my servant, but is a good servant. You see the point? He was not any servant, but he was a good servant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A servant with a good heart. A servant that listened to the instructions. The servant that follow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he fulfilled every duty in order to make his boss happy. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was a good servant. And they will only call you a good servant if they see the quality of your heart. If they see the result of your job. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the relationship here is between the boss and the servant. And they are connected because of the job that the servant is providing for the boss. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the boss was happy with him. That's why when he became sick, he said, no, I can't lose such a servant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't want to lose him. Amen.
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 You don't believe it. This is a boss that is going after a servant. Normally, a servant is supposed to go after the boss. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when he has so many servants, he will just ignore him, forget about him. Amen.
Amen.
Let's concentrate on those who are still strong and they can still provide a good service. But no, because of the quality of the job this servant was providing, he said, no, I don't want to lose this man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But let's see the part of the servant. In order to your boss to come after you, that means he found something that is important in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And the servant himself also, I believe, had a good respect. He has a respect to his boss. Amen. Because if you don't respect your boss, they just will chase you, they will sack you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But they don't want to sack you. They want you there. Because they know what you are giving them. They know what you are producing for them. That's why they want you there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And if a servant keep working for the boss, that means what? He found himself in a good place with a good boss. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because if you are working for someone who don't respect you, you will not stay no more. If you are working for someone who don't pay you, you will not stay no more. Amen.
Amen.
If you are doing a job, even though they are paying you well, but you don't have a peace in that place, you will leave. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But he didn't leave. He stayed there. The Bible says what? Not just he lacked his boss, not just he lacked his job, but he lacked the people, the nation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This servant lacked the nation. Amen.
Amen.
And because he lacked the nation, they were Christian. The Bible said what? He built the church for them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was somebody that everybody appreciates because of the service he can provide, not just for the boss, but for the entire nation. Amen.
Amen.
That means what? This servant made a good choice. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He made a good choice. He chose a good job that he can produce better, created a good job. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But he also loved the people, not just the boss, but the people, the nation. Amen.
Amen.
He appreciated them also. That's why the Bible says he made a good. That's why the boss wanted him saved. Amen.
Amen.
That's why the bosses wanted him healed. He has to go after Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Because he was a good servant. And he made a good choice of his job. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to talk to you about the prophet Elisha. The prophet Elisha, before he became a prophet, he was a servant. So he was serving Elijah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was a servant of Elijah. Elijah was his boss, and he was serving Elijah. But because of the job he was doing, the Bible says what? When God came and take away Elijah, what God has done? He took all the power of Elijah, gave it, transferred it to Elisha. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? Because Elisha was a good servant. He will serve his master. If you read his story, even before that happened, people will tell him, no, you just go. Even his own boss was telling him, don't follow me. Wait until I come back. He said, no, I will follow you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I will follow you. He kept following his boss until the last time when God came and took away Elijah. Now, he took his mantle, gave it to Elisha. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because Elisha was a good servant. He did a good job. He deserved to be honored. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you are a worker, when you are working for someone, and you are doing, oh, you are in some company, you are doing a good job. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The boss want to stick with you. The boss want to keep you in his company. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
I know people serving in some richest family, but happened that the wife or the family move away. But because they know that this is our servant, this is good, they will take him also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why they have to take you? Because they know what you are giving them, what you are providing for them. Amen.
Amen.
But if you are not good, they will not take you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But in your job, you cannot be good if you are not working in a place of peace. If there is no peace, you cannot be good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If in your job, in your workplace, there is no good relationship, you cannot be good. You cannot produce well. Amen. In your workplace, if they don't respect you, you cannot do well. Amen.
Amen.
The respect must be mutual. They like you, you like them. They respect you, they honor you, you honor them. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. When they honor you, and you are doing a good job, you will enjoy the place. And you want to do better. You want to improve yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because of the good choice you made. Elisha received the anointing of his boss because God took away his boss. And he now became a prophet. And in that olden time, a prophet supposed to have a servant that follow him, that serve him. He was a servant of Elijah. Now he became boss. And he found Gehazi as his servant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Gehazi was serving Elisha. And he will do all the job for him. But Gehazi has a problem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Gehazi has a problem. He did something that was very, very wrong. And this only one thing wrong cost him a life, cost him a job, cost him a position. He lose his blessing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A general came from Syria that was sick. I came to Israel to meet the prophet, to pray for him and to heal him. The same that they send somebody to go and call Jesus to come to pray for this servant. Amen.
Amen.
And when Naaman came to Israel, and are putting the story short, and Elisha prayed for him. Actually, he didn't pray for him. He sent him to go wash himself 7 times in the river Jordan. Hallelujah.
Amen.
After that, he found out that he was cured. He was healed from his problem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And because the man of God helped him, he wanted to give some gifts. But the man of God refused to receive this gift. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, no, it's no problem. I did it for God. Feel free. I'm okay. You don't need to give me gifts. Amen.
Amen.
And they went away. As they was going, the servant, Gehazi, the servant, start thinking, no, this man is rich. He's a general. And he gave a lot of things to my boss. My boss don't want them. No, I have to go and get something from them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I didn't tell his boss. He just found a way and followed them and meet them and tell them, now, look, my boss sent me for you to give him some present. Because just when you left just when you left, he received some visitor. He don't know how to help them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And this man, the general, gave him some good stuff. He came back. He went to his home and hide them. Then when he came to meet his boss, the prophet Elisha asked him, "What have you done?" He said, "No. Where have you been?" "No, I've been just here." He said, "No, I saw you when you went to get some gift." Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the prophet said what? "Because you did that, because this one is stealing." Amen.
Amen.
He said, "Stealing, because you stole in my bag beyond me. You went and received present when you don't need to. Then the problem that the general has have to pass on you." Amen.
Amen.
And Gehazi become leprous. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's how he lose his job. That's how he lose his blessing. And the prophets told him, "Look, the problem here, it will be on you. Not just you, but entire your family. That means your children are going to have the same problem. Your grandchildren, they're going to be also leprous like you. Because you play with God." He said, this is no time to steal. This is no stealing time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is no time to go and collect gifts from people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Gehazi did a bad choice. Amen.
Amen.
He did a bad choice. The same like Judas. Judas was one of the apostles, was following Jesus. But his mind was money-minded. Amen.
Amen.
He wanted just to make money. Hallelujah.
Amen.
At the end, he got money, but he ended up killing himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what I want you to understand, in your life, bad choice can make you miserable. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you do bad choice, your life become full of misery. Amen.
Amen.
And one of the things that you cannot miss in your life is how to choose your job, your profession. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why you see today people changing job. Here you see, tomorrow is there, next day is there. They don't know what to do, and they don't know where to be. Because of bad choice. Amen.
Amen.
And people are changing school. Today they study law, they don't finish, they move to economy, they don't finish, they move somewhere else. They keep moving. Because when they go study this thing, they find out that, "No, I'm not enjoying it. I don't want to be a lawyer." Then they change. They go do something else. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Yeah, sometimes it's normal when you are not on your real position. When it's early on your early stage of your life, everybody go through this. You don't know how to choose. You don't know how to decide. And you start trying everywhere. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But once you are mature, you are prepared to take your job serious, and you make the mistake of doing a bad choice, it will cost your life seriously. Amen.
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 I remember when I was young, I was thinking, "Oh, I need to study. I wanted to be architect. I wanted to be architect." And I tell my brother, "No, because I like to build a house. I want to be architect." And my brother told me, "In this country, there are only one company that hire architect. If they don't receive you, what gonna be? What gonna happen to you?" Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Then I start thinking, and they start giving me examples. "You know, this guy is an architect, but he don't work because there's no company here." Amen.
Amen.
And I have to change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sometimes it happens to us. You choose to study something. When you finish, then you find out that, no, I don't like it. Or I have to go work in another country. Maybe in another city. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I know somebody had a problem, a court case. They pay him a lot of money in Africa. They pay him a lot of money, and he took money to build a 5-star hotel in a village where there are no richest people. They are all poor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, this is bad choices. What he has is in his mind is good. To build an hotel is something good. But the position was wrong. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because once you have a hotel, you will make money. But you go and build a first-class hotel in the village where everybody's poor. Amen.
Amen.
You see, bad choices, bad decision. Amen.
Amen.
And I want to encourage you, concentrate on your life. Know how to make the choice of your life, mainly of your job. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't just choose because you see somebody doing that. I remember my daughter, the elder one, when she finished, she wanted to go, she finished college, and she was telling me, oh, daddy, I want to be a teacher because I saw my teacher. What they do is good. I said, listen, you know, I've been a teacher all my life. Teacher and nurse, they don't pay them well. In every country, everywhere. Sorry if anybody is a teacher here or not, it's a nurse. Amen.
Amen.
In every country, all the country in the world, teacher is the one who gives you knowledge. But get everywhere, you find out they are struggling every day because they don't pay them well. Amen.
Amen.
Those people who drive, they drive the train, they pay them £32,000, whatever they say. But the teacher, they pay them 20, 90, 15. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why they're striking everywhere, all the time, everywhere, in every country. Nurses, the same. They're the one who help us to be healthy. But they don't pay them well. I don't know why these things happen. Not just in England, everywhere. In France or in Africa, every country will go. It's the same. And I don't understand that. Why that? Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 We call them sergeants. You know, sergeants, they don't move. When you are sergeant, you will stay all your life sergeant. Amen. You prepare people, they become whatever, captain, major, they become whatever they can become. They pass you. And you stay sergeant in the army all your life. Amen. This is the job of teacher and nurses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Once you select a wrong job, it will be hard in your life. It will be very, very hard in your life. But selecting your job is something that you need to think about it and pray about it. Ask God to lead you, to guide you in order for you to make a good choice. When once you miss this, all your life is going to be messed up. All your life is going to be messed up. I see people, I know we followed one case here. This lady was working as a journalist in BBC, but he had to quit his job because he don't enjoy it, to become a teacher. Everybody, it was in the newspaper, everybody was thinking, oh, he's getting a lot of money on the BBC, but why can she quit? She explained, she said, no, I work in the BBC, they pay me well, but I don't feel happy. Amen.
Amen.
Because it's not the thing that I love, it's not the thing that I like. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He has to resign to become a teacher. Amen.
Amen.
Think about that, because there will be many, many years that you will lose for nothing. because you were in the bad place.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be in a place where you feel free. Be in a job that you love. You like to do it. Amen.
Amen.
Some job they you lack it, they don't pay you well. But because you lack it, you will stay there and keep praying. God will provide for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And the second thing, if you make a bad choice of your partner in the life, it will be your life become messed up, completely messed up. If you choose a bad husband or a bad wife, you will be crying all your entire life, all the rest of your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 You need to know how to select your future wife or your future husband. Don't just follow them because they are beautiful, like we say now, they are beautiful. Don't just follow them because you saw their leg and you are there. Oh, she got great legs. Amen.
Amen.
That will take you nowhere. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Know how to select your future wife or your future husband. Don't just follow them because they look nice. No, looking nice is not enough. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Don't just follow them because they have a good job. Good job is not enough. Amen.
Amen.
I want him because he's a pastor. Being a pastor is not enough. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because he's a pastor in my church. I love him because he's a pastor in my church. No. This is not a fact for you to accept them to be your husband because he's a pastor. No. How many pastors are divorcing now? Day after day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I know this pastor in Nigeria. God, he said God told him that to impregnate 20 women in the church. He said God told him. Shady, are you follow it? Did you follow it? Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Don't just follow them because they are pastor. They will give you bad prophecy. They will give you bad stuff. And you will accept it in name of God. But they are lying to you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Know how to select, how to choose your future husband, your future wife. The Bible says it's better to live in the desert than to have a quarreling wife. Amen.
Amen.
Mainly women, they are very noisy. When they start, you will have no peace in your home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you got the wrong one, when they start talking, you will have no peace at home. Amen.
Amen.
That's why you see many, many, many men, you find them in the pub. They are closing the pub, but he don't want to leave. He's still there. He don't want to go home. Because he know, when I go home, they're going to be fire at home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 If you select a bad wife, you will regret it entire life. If you select a bad husband, you will be crying entire life. And there's nobody can help you in that situation once you are in. Yeah, you may divorce tomorrow, find another one. But that's time that the time that you bring together, it will stay in your memory forever. And the pain that they will cause you, it will stay in your soul forever. Amen.
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 And normally our dream is to find someone, the first one, to be the last one also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 No one go to partnership in order to divorce tomorrow. No. We want to stick with them, to stay with them. But stay with them when they respect you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't just stay with them because they give give me a lot of money. We have this sister in the church. Ah, he beat me, but he gave me a lot of money. She was saying that. But today they are not together anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I like him because he gave me a lot of money. He worked for the rich and he gave me a lot of money. Amen. This is not the case. You need to select someone who understands you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who respect you. Who honor you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody who supports you in your vision. Who is there for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 If you have a friend or boyfriend that don't respect you, don't marry them. Don't start thinking, I will marry him because I will take him to the church, then I will change him. No, it's not your duty to change people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If they are wrong now and you are thinking now, tomorrow I will change them, then you are lying yourself. You are kidding to yourself. Amen.
Amen.
You are not called to change people. You are called only to change yourself.
Amen.
Not to change somebody else. Don't marry somebody who is bad. You stick to them to say no. I know I'm a Christian. I will be praying and God will change them. This is a big mistake you're going to be doing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Know how to select your wife. I know somebody in the Bible who was a husband. They were a good couple. But the wrong thing was she was supporting the husband in the wrong thing. Amen.
Amen.
Even when the husband was lying, she's still there support them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
At the end, you heard the story of Sapphira. She died. Why? Because she agreed with the husband to go and lie to the apostles. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the husband died, she still stick there with the lies of the husband. At the end, she also has to follow. Amen.
Amen.
Support your husband in the good thing, not in the bad thing. Amen.
Amen.
It doesn't matter if the bad thing is making a lot of money. Don't support them in that. Please. Remember, I preached to you once. I say your wife or your husband is the person that has the key to take you, to help you to go to heaven or to go to hell. If you support them in the bad thing, he will carry you to hell. Or she will carry you to hell. Amen.
Amen.
But if you are supporting each other in the good thing, then you will support each other also to go to a good place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Know how to select your husband or your wife. And we as Africans, we say, listen to the advice of your parents. Amen.
Amen.
It's not your parents to decide for you, but listen to their advice. There are two different things. Them deciding for you is something else. But I always advise to you that listen to their advice. If they say yes, yes. If they say no, maybe find out why they say no. But listen to them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you don't want to listen to them because my boyfriend is nice, he look good, he smell good. One day, you will be crying alone in the bathroom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know about Samson. The parents say, you're not supposed to marry this lady. Listen to them. At the end, you know this story, he died early because of having a wrong wife. Amen.
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 And I will also encourage, we don't have time to read all this stuff. I was not prepared to preach because I was the one to preach. It's always good, I will encourage the mother, always good to be a praying mother. Pray for your kid. I'm not talking to the fathers, I'm talking firstly to the mothers. Amen.
Amen.
If you have a praying mother, you are blessed. I stick with them and respect them. Amen.
Amen.
But you mother, I want to encourage you to be praying mothers, mothers who pray for the kid. The boys and the girl, pray for them. Remember, Satan is so clever that just because of Moses, because of the birth of Moses, he couldn't get Moses. He ordained to every child from 0 to 2 to be killed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because he didn't know how to get Moses. He didn't know the position of the age of Moses. That's why every king should be killed. And the same happened to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
They killed every child that was born in the area. Every male child. Why? Because they wanted to kill Jesus. And they didn't know Jesus was already run away already in Egypt. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why I'm saying that? Because the enemy knows. He knows how to prepare. He has so many strategies how to get you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why don't wait when your children are big. Then you start praying for them to have a good husband or good wife. It's late. Because the enemy has already so bad things down there. Pray for them since they are little. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Since they are little, start praying for them. For God to prepare a good husband for them, good wife for them. I pray for your family. Pray for your family. Mother, be a praying mother who pray for the king. Sometimes, some things you don't need to be talking, screaming, shouting. Just go in the bedroom, lay down, lay your hand in the bed, and start praying, start declaring word. Amen.
Amen.
Even for your husband. If you say your husband is behaving bad, don't wait them until they come. When they are out, you go to the bedroom, touch their clothes, touch the trousers, put your hand on that, pray for them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pray good word that God will change them. And I want to encourage you to be a praying mother. The mother that prays for the husband. The mother that prays for the children. I always say in my own way of saying, I say, mothers are the heater. Wait, I'm running away from here. I don't know why. Mothers are the heater at home. Like a heater at home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When your house is cold, what you do? You open the heater. Once you open the heater, what happens?
Yeah.
Things change. Amen.
Amen.
When your house is too hot, what you do? You close the heater, you open the window a little bit. Then the freshness of outside come in. Change things. Mother are called to change things, to change condition and situation at home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But you children, be in connection with your mother, with your parents. Talk to them. Whatever you make your decision, yeah, it's to you to decide. But listen to the advice of your parents. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't decide. Don't do things in secret. Don't do things in secret. You meet a boyfriend in secret, everything in secret, then they will impregnate you in secret also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then you bring crying at home. You come home crying. Your parents, they will just stay in with open mouth because they are surprised. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They never saw you with a boyfriend or a girlfriend, but they just seeing you with new position. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? Because you don't talk to them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are, you find somebody is serious, oh, you are serious, you find a girl, you are serious with them, talk to your parents. Nothing is wrong with that. Things go wrong. Why? Mainly for us African. Because you do things in hiding. You're thinking, oh, if I tell my dad, they will kill me. If I tell my mom, they will kill me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No, they will not kill you. They will advise you. And if they tell you, no, no with this boy. Oh, no with this girl. They know why they're telling you that. Amen.
Amen.
In our time, our parents will decide. No, they will advise you, but before they advise you, they will investigate. But you guys today, you just found them and you got married to them. And tomorrow, 3 days, one day after you find out that it's your cousin, then you start crying. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Because you never told your parents. You never asked your parents. Amen.
Amen.
You just found them, oh, I find a boy, a good boy. They live because they live far away from you. Ah, we are from the same country. We came from the same country. But when the parents, they want to sit down and talk, they find out that, oh, you are related. Then what happened? You start crying, no, I cannot leave him because I love him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? Because you kept it secret. Talk to your parents. Share things with your parents. They will not kill you. I tell my children, I'm not a ball of fire. I will not burn you. Even if I don't like it, I will not burn you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We African, we say, it's better to give direction to the tree when it's smaller than waiting when it's bigger. You cannot do it anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you see your tree is small, it's bending, at that time you can come and put it right and direct it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But once it's big, you cannot do nothing. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen to your parent is important. And there are two things very, very important in your life. If you miss how to choose your job, you are lost. If you miss how to choose to select your partner, you are lost. Amen.
Amen.
If you miss these 2 points, you are completely lost in your life. You can get a job that pays you a lot of money, but you will never be happy. You can have a husband that everybody see is nice, he look good, whatever you can, any qualification you can give them, and they give you good money, but you are not happy to be with them. Amen.
Amen.
That's why you see many wives of many bosses, they always cheat with the servant that are home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The wives of many riches always cheat with the servant at home, because the husband has no time for you. You have many meetings, you have many places to go. Amen.
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 I'm praying that you understand and you get something from this message, even though it was a big surprise for me. I never prepared it, actually. I just pick it and preach it. And I pray that God will bless us, all of us, and this message will stick in your mind, in your heart, and put it in practice. It will help you a lot in your future. Amen.
Amen.
If you are living in good family, in peaceful family, your mother and your father, they will be happy. They will have a peace about in them also. Amen.
Amen.
But if you don't have peace in your home where you live, they will also have the same problem, because they're going to be thinking on you all the time. What is going on there? Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Your job as we say, we call it, is a your breadwinner. Amen.
Amen.
It will sustain you. It will give you a good surviving strength. And your wife also is your partner for your entire life. You don't want to get married tomorrow and divorce after 2 months. It is very bad situation. Amen.
Amen.
And that's why we are telling you about the bad choices. Make a good choice. Pray. Don't just live in feeling and emotion. Know how to pray about your job, about your partner. Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you.